Be careful. Watch the load. Be careful. Watch the load.
Hasn't that driver arrived yet? Hasn't that driver arrived yet? We need to check the ballast. We need to check the ballast. The chief engineer really works hard.
The expiry date on these fire extinguishers ends in 1 month. We'll need 13 extinguishers to be replaced or refilled on shore. The expiry date on these fire extinguishers ends in 1 month. We'll need 13 extinguishers to be replaced or
Can you pump out the drain water now? Can you pump out the drain water now?
We need to do an exploration of the seabed. We need to do an exploration of the seabed.
Due to a serious lack of gas, we had to delay our cargo operations for a few days. Due to a serious lack of gas, we had to delay our cargo.
The accident happened because the access was blocked.
Those metal lockers are covered in rust.
Let's check what you've done. Have you checked all the scuppers yet?
Yes. They've already been plugged.
Great. What about the oil spill removal kit?
Yes, it's in position.
Okay. But I don't see the oil absorbent. Where is it? Have it brought immediately. You know we can't start bunkering without it. What else? The main engine is on standby now. The moorings are secured, the tanks have been sounded, and the fire hoses are positioned. Now we just have to wait until they bring the oil absorbent and we can start bunkering.
Good morning. My name is Paul Valmont. I'm an AB, and I'd like to know if there are any vacancies in your company at the moment.
What's the experience do you have?
Well, I've been working at sea for 6 years now, but only on container vessels and bulk carriers.
I'm afraid there's no opportunities at the moment, but we always keep a register of seafarers who apply to our company. So if you want to, you can fill in this form with your contact details and information about your sea experience, qualifications and training. We also need copies of your medical certificate. If it's not up to date, you'll need to arrange a medical check with your doctor. Then if anything suitable comes up, we'll get in touch.
Good morning. My name is Paul Valmont. I'm an AB, and I'd like to know if there are any vacancies in your company at the moment.
What's the experience do you have?
Well, I've been working at sea for 6 years now, but only on container vessels and bulk carriers.
I'm afraid there's no opportunity.
Glasgow VTS, this is MV Morelia, over.
MV Morelia, Glasgow VTS, over.
Information, we have problems with electricity on the bridge. Only one radar is working. I require navigational assistance, over.
Can you please repeat? Did you say you have problems with your rudder, over?
I repeat, we have problems with electricity and only one radar is working. We do not have a problem with the rudder. We require navigational assistance, over.
I don't want another accident like this to happen again. Did you make sure the motorman had the permit to work before starting the maintenance?
Yes, of course, and I gave him clear instructions what they had to do. They're skilled motormen.
So what job were they doing?
They were changing the circlips and O-rings on the main engine rockers.
So, how come they were scolded? Didn't they have their PPE on?
They did, but they decided on their own to remove the thermometer pocket in the cooling water system to ease the access to the rockers. They shouldn't have done it without my approval.
So were you supervising them personally?
Well, no. I was busy doing the weekly report.
That's no excuse. It doesn't matter how experienced they are. You should have been there watching them. You were really lucky they weren't badly burnt. Have you ever had to put out a fire?
Oh, yes. It was 3 years ago.
How did it happen?
At night. The fire alarm sounded and the watch officer on the bridge made an announcement.
So, where was the fire? In the engine room?
Actually, the fire had broken out in the workshop. The watch motorman had started welding work to repair the purifier drum without a permit to work or taking precautions.
Was he alone in there?
Oh, yes. And a spark got into the diesel oil drip tray.
You see that vessel dock there and those seafarers hanging over the rails?
Yes, what about them?
Well, they're not real.
What?
They're dummies. You know, like you get in a shop for modeling clothes?
Yes, you're right. Things don't look too good for us if they're recruiting dummies now.
You know why they're there, don't you?
Is it some kind of research the IMO is carrying out? Or are they trying out a new type of PPE in heavy weather conditions?
No, it's to stop pirate attacks.
Excuse me, but there seems to be a problem with the air conditioning in my cabin.
What's the problem exactly?
I don't know. You're the electrician. All I know is it doesn't seem to be working properly. It's unbearably hot in here.
Okay, let's have a look. Well, it doesn't seem to be anything serious. Looks like the switch could be faulty. Yes, I'll soon have it mended. I remember the incident on board my ship in January this year. It was really bad weather, with high winds and poor visibility. We were carrying a cargo of pipes, but as we were rounding the Cape of Good Hope, the pipes broke loose on deck. At the time, I was on watch on the bridge. The second officer heard a loud noise and noticed the pipes were loose, so he immediately informed the captain. The captain altered course to reduce the rolling and then ordered a team to go down on deck and secure the pipes. The problem was caused by the movement of the ship and some lashings breaking. But luckily, the deck crew were able to lever the pipes into a secure position and lash them down again. I remember the incident on board my ship in January this year. It was really bad weather, with high winds and poor visibility. We were carrying a cargo of pipes, but as we were rounding the Cape of Good Hope, the pipes broke loose on deck. At the time, I was on watch on the bridge. The second officer heard a loud noise and noticed the pipes were loose, so he immediately informed the captain. The captain altered course to reduce the rolling and then ordered a team to go down on deck and secure the pipes. The problem was caused by the movement of the ship and some lashings breaking. But luckily, the deck crew were able to lever the pipes into a secure position and lash them down again.
Hello, I'm Dr. Johns. We got your message. So, what's the problem?
Thanks for coming, Doctor. One of the seafarers had a fall on deck and has injured his leg. He seemed okay when he went off duty, but this morning he was able to dress himself and has difficulty moving. The ship's doctor is with him now. He hasn't touched his leg and said it was better to get a second opinion.
Okay, so let's have a look at the patient.
He's in the sick bay. This way, please.
Hello, I'm Dr. Johns. We got your message. So, what's the problem?
Thanks for coming, Doctor. One of the seafarers had a fall on deck and has injured his leg. He seemed okay when he went off duty, but this morning he was able to dress himself and has difficulty moving. The ship's doctor is with him now. He hasn't touched his leg and said it was better to get a second opinion.
Okay, so let's have a look at the patient.
He's in the sick bay. This way, please.
Look, I'm not accepting those tins of tomatoes.
Why? What's the problem?
Just have a look at the date. What's the date today?
It's the 5th of November.
And what's the date on that tin?
The 2nd of August, so? What's your point?
Well, have a look at the year. That tin is 3 years out of date.
Look, I've eaten tins of tomatoes that are 5 years out of date and you wouldn't know it. They keep forever.
Well, that might be your opinion, but I'm not taking them, and that's final. Look, I'm not accepting those tins of tomatoes.
Why? What's the problem?
Just have a look at the date. What's the date today?
It's the 5th of November.
And what's the date on that tin?
The 2nd of August, so? What's your point?
Well, have a look at the year. That tin is 3 years out of date.
Look, I've eaten tins of tomatoes that are 5 years out of date and you wouldn't know it. They keep forever.
Well, that might be your opinion, but I'm not taking them, and that's final.
Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is MV Southern Star. My position, 25 degrees north, 56 degrees west. I am on fire in engine room. Fire is not under control. We are flooding the engine room with carbon dioxide. I require assistance immediately. Over.
Two motormen were given a permit to work to carry out routine maintenance on the main engine on board a Ro-Ro passenger ferry. This work included changing the circlips and the O-rings on the main engine rockers, but when they were removing the thermometer pocket and the engine's cooling system, there was a problem with the pressure and they were sprayed with boiling water. Their legs were badly burnt and they needed hospital treatment. Fortunately, both men escaped serious injury.
Did you hear what happened to that vessel last week? The one with the false documentation?
Yes. I can't believe the master did that. He's certainly paying for it now.
Yeah, they're pretty strict here. I reckon he'll be fined thousands of dollars and probably imprisoned for several years.
What's the maximum punishment here again?
It's $10,000 per violation and 6 months in prison. I actually worked with him about 10 years ago when I was a third officer. Even at that time, he had a grounding that resulted in an oil spill. He's trouble.
Yes, well, he won't be getting into any more trouble for a long time.
Did you hear what happened to that vessel last week? The one with the false documentation?
Yes. I can't believe the master did that. He's certainly paying for it now.
Yeah, they're pretty strict here. I reckon he'll be fined thousands of dollars and probably imprisoned for several years.
What's the maximum punishment here again?
It's $10,000 per violation and 6 months in prison. I actually worked with him about 10 years ago when I was a third officer. Even at that time, he had a grounding that resulted in an oil spill. He's trouble.
Yes, well, he won't be getting into any more trouble for a long time.
I remember one strange passage where we had a chain of stoppages. We were proceeding off the coast of Mauritania in the fishing zone when we suddenly came to a stop.
Why? Was it engine trouble or a blackout?
Well, that happened later, but at first it turned out that the ship's propeller had become caught up in fishing nets.
What happened?
Well, we had to get a diver to free the fishing nets from the propeller, but then just a couple of hours later we stopped again as a result of a blackout. We had to stop two more times because of this.
Excuse me, can you tell me where I can find the hospital?
Yes, it's in Bridge Street. It's about 5 minutes away by taxi, or you can take the number 42 bus. That'll take about 15 minutes to get there.
Can I walk there?
Oh yeah, it's actually quicker than the bus, because you take a shortcut through the supermarket car park. You should get there in about 10 minutes.
Excuse me, can you tell me where I can find the hospital?
Yes, it's in Bridge Street. It's about 5 minutes away by taxi, or you can take the number 42 bus. That'll take about 15 minutes to get there.
Can I walk there?
Oh yeah, it's actually quicker than the bus, because you take a shortcut through the supermarket car park. You should get there in about 10 minutes.
inch. Mechanical. Glove. Scupper. Scupper above rope glove. Scupper. Above. Rope. Rope. Glove. Chin. Specific. Enclosed. 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 Sound. Bulwark. Bulwark. Bulwark hull. Bulwark hull sump pump. Bulwark hull sump pump.